ओके सो हे हाय गाइस, हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल एलुसिडेट, एंड आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन माय लेक्चर 6 ऑफ जावा सीरीज. सो गाइस, ऑन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर, व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू फॉरगेट अबाउट एक्सेल इन आवर डेटा ड्रिवन टेस्टिंग, राइट? एंड नाउ व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू यूज जेसॉन डेटा. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ जेसॉन, वी आर गोइंग टू रीड दैट पर्टिकुलर डेटा एंड वी आर गोइंग टू पैरामीटराइज इट somewhere, and then we are going to use it onto our test cases. So it is that simple, really, believe me, it's that simple. Okay, so what we were doing in Excel, so in Excel, that you know, we were creating an Excel file, and then we were creating four different methods to count number of rows, number of columns, getting string cell data, getting numeric cell data, and after that we were, you know, passing it onto from one place to another place, and then creating a data provider and then using that onto our test cases, right? But over here, you just create your data provider method, your file should be ready. And the only thing, if you want to even learn, this is the first time I'm saying, if you just want to learn something, just learn that you have to make use of file reader class and JSON parser class, and that is it. These are the two things that you really need to learn, because if you tend to forget, then how you are going to, you know, code it. So these are the only two things that you need to learn, that I have to go ahead and I have to make use of this file reader class. And the second thing was that I had to go and I had to make use of JSON parser class. That is it. Believe me, that is it. Okay. So now, instead of going through all this hassle and everything, creating a class and then storing some values, blah, 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 we'll just create our JSON file and then we'll start using it. So instead of wasting time, let's get back to the lecture in doing the hands-on part, okay? So guys, here I am. And let's say this was a method that I created. I had to parameterize it. Onto my previous lectures, I have shown you that, you know, you had to pass your string username, password, and using add data provider, and that was getting passed from the data provider to here and from here to here. So this is the same method that I have already noted it down over here in order to save 5-7 minutes of time. But the real concept begins from here. So as in the sheet, what I have mentioned is that first of all, you need to create a data provider method. So simple, we'll do that, okay? But even before that, you need to have your JSON data. Let's say this is my JSON data. I'm not going to into very detail how the JSON data works, or what is the architecture, what is the schema. But as of now, those who know about JSON data, fine as of now, okay? So this is the key and this is the value. This is the key, this is the value, this is the key, and this is the value. Okay, so everything over here is like, this is a particular array, and this array contains three objects: object one at location 0, object one at location 1, and object 2 or 012 at location 2. So there are three different kinds of objects over here, right? And now we have to go ahead and use this particular data. We are going to parameterize it. Previously, our data was kind of, you know, when we used to store it Excel, we used to store it into this particular form: username, password, username and password, right? But over here in JSON, it is stored in the form of key value pair. I hope you guys have that basic level of idea, right? Because my lecture, I am assuming that you know a basic thing about JSON. I'm not going into that level of deep, right? So without wasting time, so this is your JSON data that has already been created by me. It's very simple. This square bracket is representing an array of elements, and every element is an object over here, separated by a comma. You can see the comma written over here, right? Okay. So the very first thing that you needed to do is that first create a data provider method. So, okay, I'll go and create it. And even before we start writing coding, especially for those, again, I'm reiterating, I've seen people learning the coding stuff. They learn the code line by line, what should be written first, what should be written second. So for them, I'm going to take a little bit of time over here and I'll show them how to code. I mean, even in n number of tutorials or videos, if you go and see, the market is open to each one and everyone. I have seen people start writing the code from here and then second line of code and then third line of code and then fourth line of code. It looks like they are only already automated. I mean, they knew each and everything in advance, right? So I'm not that level of advanced kind of guy. I learned coding by having an idea of what to do, when to do. So in the same way, I'll help you guys in order to understand so that you do not think and ask me questions like, how did you know that that this was the very first line? How did you know that this is going to be your second line, right? Because I've seen people asking these kinds of questions, okay? So first thing is that go ahead and create a particular data provider method. So let's say this is the name of a method is like getting data from JSON file. Okay. So this is the method that I have created and I'm going to create it. And now the only thing you need to remember is that you need to make use of this thing. Read or load the file using file reader class. So why we are loading the file with the help of file reader class? What is the even use of reading the file, or what is the use of loading the file? Because if you do not have this particular file, then from where are you going to read the data? So the file is already created at this particular location. I would show you, I'm going to show you the location where this file is created. And in order to load this file, you have just make use of this particular class, and the name of the class is file reader class. That is it. Read equals new, and I have created an object over here of file reader class. And in order to load it, you need to pass the location of your JSON data file. So I'll go to my this project Excel. This is my JSON data file. I'll just copy it. It's as simple as that. It is like the way we used to copy it in the case of Excel sheet. I'm just copying the location of my JSON data file. Okay. Cancel, paste it over here. So this is the first step that was required, and it is showing some error, which means that, you know, there's a declaration kind of thing, and I've just imported it. Fine. This was the first step. Very simple, very easy. You have just loaded your file over here with the help of file reader class. Okay. And I've created an object of this particular file. Simple. Now, getting back to my second step. What is my second step? I've noted it down. We are going to pass the JSON data using JSON parser class. So make use of this particular class as well. JSON parser, let's say create an object like parsing, JSON parsing. This is the name of the object, and new JSON parser. Okay. I hope till now things are cleared, because I already told you guys in the initial of the lecture that you need to make sure that you remember these two classes, because you are going to make use of this class. And why? This class will help you to load your file, and this class will help you in parsing the JSON data. What is my JSON data? Whatever is present over here is my JSON data, right? These all objects are my JSON data. So in order to pass JSON data, there is a class named as JSON parser. It will help you. This class will help you to pass the data, to pass the JSON data present in the JSON file. If you want to remember something, then remember this particular concept. If you want to learn this concept, remember this particular line. Okay. Why we are using JSON parser class? Because it will help us to pass the JSON data present in the JSON file. That is it. It's that simple. Okay. So now let's say I'm a fresher kind of person. I have just started coding and I'm not clear now what to do. I mean, like, I have loaded the file. Why I've loaded the file? Because this file is required. If you want to read something, then there has to be a file. So as Abhinav said that, you know, we have to load the particular file with the help of file reader class. I did that. And then in order to parse that data, I have to make use of JSON parser class. And I have also created an object. So what to do? So start thinking like into the bigger scope that now you what to do. Now what can be done? So you have to start parsing your data with the help of this particular class. And what is meant by parsing? To parse data information means to break it down into component parts so that it can be analyzed, categorized, and understood. This is the basic definition which I found useful, because I have seen people making use of this term parsing data, and still nobody is able to understand what is meant by actual term parsing, right? So parsing data basically means that you are going to break it down in order to analyze or to categorize, and so that you can understand what kind of syntax it is using, right? If it would have been Egyptian kind of stuff, let's say it's written Egyptian, then you have to parse this data as well, so that you can understand what is written in the Egyptian, ancient Egyptian language, right? Maybe it might have been written in that particular fashion. I don't know that. Okay, so now start thinking that you have to do something with the help of this particular object. We have not created it just for the sake of creating it. Now what we are going to do, that we are going to parse the data, we are going to break the data. And where is that data present? That data is present over here onto this particular file. So use this particular servant kind of thing. As I told you in my family example, there was a servant who, with the help of which I was, you know, calling your father, your mother, and your brother. So that kind of stuff you can imagine at this point of time. So in order to move forward, JSON parsing dot parse the data, right? And it is asking me what you want to parse. You want to parse the data present onto this particular file, or let's say this reference variable is holding that entire data. Just imagine at this point of time. Okay, add throws declaration that has gone. Okay, so till now what we have done, that we have to parse this particular data. Okay, and the return type of this parse method is an object. So see, I'm not learning anything. I have not learned this code. I just hover the mouse over this particular method parse, and it is saying that it is gonna return something sort of object kind of thing, right? So I'm going to store it in the form of object. Let's say this is a Java object. Not let's say, this is actually a Java object. Okay, so three steps we have done. We loaded the file, we created an object of JSON parser class. Why? Because with the help of this object I can call the methods defined onto JSON parser class. So now we have started parsing the data present onto this over here, and since it was returning a reference variable or something kind of stuff of an object type, so I stored it in an object variable. Okay, so till now nothing has been learned. Everything we are doing line by line, and because it is required to do, this is why we are doing it. Okay, so now what will happen, that since let's say all the data is with this Java object, right? All the data is inside this, of all this particular data, let's say of this particular file, is inside a Java object. Okay, but we are going to parse JSON data, so you cannot parse JSON data with the help of Java object. So you have to convert it, you have to convert this person into a JSON kind of object. Okay, let's say in your organization there are some works which are being done only by a CEO itself. A CEO of an organization has the authority, let's say, to remove a person or to remove a person or to add a person to their organization, right? And let's say if it is an employee, so it cannot take the decisions of a CEO of an organization. So if you want this person, Java object, to take decisions like a CEO of an organization, you have to convert him, you have to assign him the post of CEO. Only then he can go ahead and take decisions like a CEO. I hope I'm making sense. So this is why I'm going to typecast it, or I'm going to convert it into a JSON object, because only JSON object can, you know, pass this data or fetch this data. Okay, so this is the reason I am going to convert it into JSON object. JSON object, because we are dealing with JSON data, so you need to have a JSON object, right? If you are going to a village, you need a proper villager in order to guide you. You cannot call someone from United Kingdom to guide you onto your particular village. So in that particular fashion also you can understand why we are, you know, converting it. And then you have to store it in the form of a JSON object. JSON object. Okay. So now let's say this was a Java object, this was a servant, and now it has become the CEO. I have changed this servant into a CEO kind of stuff, and now you can take decisions like a CEO. Similarly, now since we are dealing with the JSON data, I have converted that data who was having entire thing onto this file into a JSON object, and now we can go ahead with to and play with this JSON object. Okay, so now what this JSON object is going to do? This JSON object is going to fetch me values for this particular key, this entire value. Okay, so JSON object dot get object key. What is my key? What is my key over here? My key over here is login details. Just copy it out. Okay. So guys, I'm not learning anything. I've already told you, do not learn this line by line. I've seen people getting confused that why this happened and why equal and why people, I've seen people start writing the coding from left to right. If you start writing your coding from right to left, I think you would be able to learn Java much, much better. Okay. So now I'm going to get the details. So what it is going to return me, right? It is going to return me. See, this is the key and this is the value. And what is this value stored in? This value is stored in the form of an array. It means that I have to again store it in the form of an array kind of stuff. Okay. So coming back over here, where is my code? Yeah. So this array over here, as I told you guys, is a JSON array. Just analyze this particular code. This is the key and the value it is returning is giving me a JSON array. So it means that everything needs to be get stored into JSON array. So now JSON array, let's say JSON array equals this. And now there will be some issue. It is saying that, you know, it cannot be resolved to a particular type. Why? Because I've not typecasted it or I've not changed it over here. Simply import it. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. Right? Sorry. Okay. So this key was returning the value in the form of an array. So this is the reason why I stored it in the form of an array, right? And now I am onto this particular array. And this array has three locations, three objects. Object at location 0, object at location 1, object at location 2. This is the reason I'm going to do something again next over here, right? So I'm going to extract all this data with the help of for loop. Okay. And I'm going to store it in the form of a string array. Okay. So first is go to a for loop. Then it will make more sense. Okay. So int, let's say I equals from 0, comma I less than, the size of the array is 0, 1, 2, that is 3 elements. So less than array dot size, the size of this array, 3 elements. So JSON array dot size colon I double plus. Okay. So I'm incrementing it one by one. Okay. So till now, I'm going to do is that I am going to extract this value from this particular location 0. Okay, so how I'm going to do that? Let's say JSON array dot get at index I, that is at index 0, there would be some element present, right? And what kind of element is that? That element is itself a JSON object. Okay, so I'll just store it in the form of सॉरी data. Okay, so now with the help of this particular array which was containing all my array, I am seeing that dot get the first element at location 0. And what this element is, this element is in itself, entire element is an object. So this is the reason why I've converted into an object and I stored it into a particular object, right? And with the help of this object, and now since again we have converted into object, with the help of this object dot get key, object dot get key, right? Now this is what now I am going to do that. So I'll just copy it out, dot get key, right? So this is how you are, what is my key? My key is username dot get. What is my key? My key is password. Okay, so this is my key, and what it is going to return me this time, just see over here, it is going to return me some value of type string, right? So I'm going to store it in the form of string, but right now it is in the form of some different form. I'm again going to convert it in the form of a string. Let's say username equals this, and a string, let's say password equals to this thing. You need to convert this as well. We have converted it. Okay. And now when you are going to get the output, you are going to again store it in the form of an array. So in order to store it, first you need to define an array, right? So string array of data, let's say, equals to new array of data, and should run still JSON array dot size. So for that, array of data at location I equals username plus, followed by a comma, plus password. That is it. Okay, so I made some mistake. Just one sec. Okay, guys. Sorry for the disturbance. So till now what we have done, guys, over here is that we have, you know, fetched the data using array containing data, this particular object dot get username, and it is going to return me of a value of type string. So I've stored it onto a string username uname, and the same way I am make use of this JSON object, that is array containing data dot I am getting the password. Why I am doing that? Because this is an entire object, and that object is, with the help of that object, I am going to find the value of particular key. So object dot get key, object dot get key, right? So this is what I am doing, that object dot get key, object dot get key. But since after getting the data, it is returning me value of type string, so I have stored it onto the string, and I have also converted it over here of type string so that it can be stored over here in the form of string. Okay, and whatever the value is present over here, we have just concatenated it over here, and we are going to store it onto a one dimensional array. Okay, so I don't know why this error is appearing. Okay, so for that, initially you have to define it over here, that there is an array of data, one dimensional array, and whatever the value is coming from the for loop, you have to store it over here. Okay, and if you want to see what happens, what it is returning, I'll show you guys quickly, right? So array of data, and I I've just printed it out over here, and if you want to see, I'll just make sure that I use a test annotation, and you'll see that, you know, something would definitely come in the form of a test execution. Okay, so it has got passed successfully. Where is my console? Yeah, over here is my console. So what is coming over here, just note it down at this point of time. I am getting the exact data. What was my data? Jennifer, Jason Roy, John Constantine. Okay, so if you go over here, sorry, and again I'll run it. I don't know. So this is returning me Jennifer, Jason Roy, and John Constantine. So it is returning me with the help of a comma, because I have stored it into this one dimensional array. Okay, so you do not need to learn why you are storing it over here. Why? Because it is required over here, and we are going to pass this data. We are going to pass it somewhere else. And it will be getting passed onto this particular form, right? This particular form. So this is why we are storing it onto this particular manner. And now there is not much involved over here, work involved. So what you need to do is that you have to just return it, because it is returning me an string, array of type string. So return array of data, and make sure the return type is also changed. It is of type string. Okay, remove this test annotation, because I'm going to now make it my data provider over here. So add data provider and give it a meaningful name. The name is like name equals data from JSON. That is it. Import it. I've imported it. Okay. So this was all required to do, right? This was really all. And what, coming back to the second step, it is saying me that use the created data provider onto your test case. So now we have to just use it very simply, right? So in how, in order to use it, this was the function that I created earlier. Okay, so what I was doing it over here is that, you know, I was passing some parameters over here, and these things were getting passed over here, right? So let's say I am getting the data from this data provider in a form of a string array, right? Or a string. So let's give it me the name of the string, give it any name like all data. I've just given it a name, right? And the data that I was getting over here, I have shown you onto console, it was appearing in the form of comma, right? Like Jennifer comma Jennifer at 123. So I'm going to split that data, all data dot split, and I'm going to split it where this comma was found. Right, and I'm going to store it in the form of a one dimensional array like final data kind of stuff, and just store it, right? I've stored all the data over here, and this is my final data, which is going to split my data whenever it is going to contain a comma. And now if you just pass this particular thing over here, like final data element at location 0. I hope you guys know how array works. I am not going to draw the diagram of an array over here, guys, because it will again take a lot of time, and since I do have a lot of work today as well. Okay, so what I have done over here, this is your final data, all the data that was coming from here, data from JSON. I showed you that it was coming like Jennifer at 123. All the data was coming in the form of comma Jennifer comma Jennifer 123, Jason Roy comma Jason Roy at 123, right? So the data was appearing onto that particular fashion. And now what you need to do, you just needed to provide it over here. So this is my test case, add test. And what is my data provider? My data provider is data from JSON. Okay, so whatever the data was delivered by this particular stuff, it was delivering me data like Jennifer comma Jennifer at 1 2 3, right? And so this data was going from here to here, right? This is the reason I stored it onto an all data kind of string, and I splitted that particular data. So now this would be getting removed, right? And the values I am going to store it by one in the form of an index. So at zero position it will give me this, and one position it's gonna give me this value. This is the reason why I have stored it onto a final data kind of string array. Okay, and now I have passed the value over here. Nothing is hard coded. You cannot see any data hard coded over here onto this entire things over here, right? So if you just click it over here and you just run this particular test case, something would happen over here. And what would happen, I'll show you. So my test case has started running with the help of add test test ng annotation. So the very first time it is going to put Jennifer and Jennifer at 1 2 3. See, it has put Jennifer at 1 2 3, and now again a second value, or for the second value a second instance is being opened up by the Chrome driver, and again it is going to put some value over there, right? So first time it entered Jennifer, it is taking some time, I don't know why. And then it has put Jason Roy over here, and the third time it will put John Constantine over here, right? So entire thing got automated in a very easy and in a very fast manner. I don't think that it was very, very complex at any point of time. So I'll just reiterate before closing this particular session. The only thing that was required, that you need to learn that you need to make use of file reader class and JSON parser. And after that, we just coded everything on our own. What we did is that we loaded the file. We create an object of this particular class so that we can parse the data present onto this particular location for this object. And since everything it was being returning in the form of an Java object, I stored it in the Java object. But since we were dealing with, you know, a JSON data, so I converted that JSON data into a Java object, like CEO and employee kind of example I told you guys. I converted into JSON object, and now I was getting the details. I was getting the details of this particular value of this key. It was returning me a JSON array, so I stored it into a JSON array. Okay, and after that I started writing my for loop, right? So what I did is that with the help of this JSON array, it was containing all these three elements. This is an array containing these three elements or these three objects, right? So in order to traverse them, I just started with the help of for loop, like dot get I. So at location zero, it was again returning me an object of type JSON object. So I again stored it in the form of JSON object. And when I got the JSON object, I started getting that this is a JSON object. So in this just JSON object dot get username, JSON object dot get password. So it will give me the value of these particular keys. And the value that these were returning were in the form of totally string. So again, I stored them in the form of string. Then I concatenated it and I stored it in the form of a string array, one dimensional array. This is the reason again I had to define it over here, and since I defined it over here, it is going to return me. And then simple, I just splitted the data because this data was being passed over here, and since it was containing comma kind of thing, so I splitted it and stored it into finally onto a string array. And from this array at location zero, I know the value is username and the password, whatever the value, I am fetching it and just putting it over here, right? So this is how this was all done. And you know, you do not need to create one class for reading Excel data and one class for creating data provider and a third class for running the data. Everything we are doing able to do into just one single class. Just create a data provider method and that is it. It is really that level of simple. Okay, so I hope I have made sense onto this particular lecture. Please let me know if you guys want to know any other thing. related to this particular topic. Okay, so thank you for your time and thank you for your patience. Thank you. Thanks a lot.